We can transform our Ionic application into a progressive web app using the Angular CLI. For that, let's open our terminal in the root of our project and type ng add angular PWA. Here's what that CLI schematic did for us. First, it created all of our icons in different variations. This is for when the application needs the different resolution icons depending on where it's going to be loaded. Then it created our web manifest file. In this file, we have all of the configuration for our PWA. Here you can see that we are linking to the icons and we are saying, okay, whenever we need the size 72 by 72 pixels, then this is the icon we are going to use. Also, it's adding other properties. Name is the name of your application. Short name is the short name that's going to be behind the icon. The theme color, I've seen it used differently depending on the platform. In Android, some of the times is the one that goes in the background when you're using the task switcher. This is a placeholder background color for waiting while your styles load. It's also the background color of your splash screen. The display property let us set the display of our PWA. It can take multiple values. For example, full screen means it's going to take the entire screen for the device. Standalone is similar to full screen, but it's going to show the device status bar. Minimal UI is similar to standalone, but it lets the browser choose if they show the navigation bar or not. And browser, it's basically a mobile browser. It will show the URL bar, the navigation controls, and so on. The scope variable is the scope we want to give to the PWA. It's usually just the forward slash. But if, for example, you have your application, but the PWA, you want the manifest only to affect a part of the application, like if you have your domain.com/app, then this manifest will only affect everything that's in the app folder. And the start URL is the URL you want to load when the application is entered through the icon installed on the screen. For the service worker, the CLI already did three things for us. First, it installed the package for the Angular service worker. Then it went into our app module and initialized the service worker for us. It says it's only going to be used in a production environment. And also it created a service worker configuration file. Here is where we have the configuration for our service worker. We can see that it created some asset groups. Here we're going to handle the assets of our applications and give them cache policies. For example, it created two assets group. In the first one, we see that it's giving the name of app. And this is a prefetch. This is going to load all of the essentials for our application to work. So all of the JavaScript, all of the CSS files, and the index manifest and the fab icon. When we set install mode to prefetch, what we are telling it is, you are going to load and you're going to get all of these files as soon as the user navigates to your application. And below you can see that it created another configuration. This is called assets. And this is basically for all of the images, fonts, and other static files we have in our domain. And here we set the install mode to lazy. This means that it won't cache these files until you navigate to pages that loads them. But the update mode is set to prefetch, meaning that if in our hosting environment, some of these file changes, it's going to download them immediately.